What came before modern humans? If you go way back, one of those weird fish with the little arm thingies. But more recently, our ancient hominid cousins. We sent Erica to Dallas to meet with one archaeologist who actually discovered a new type of archaic human, Homo naledi.
We human beings, also known as Homo sapiens, like to think we're pretty cool. After all, we are the only species that can fly a rocket to the moon, get a B+ in algebra, and bake peanut butter cookies. Be that, koalas. Today, I've traveled to the Origins exhibit at the Perot Museum in Dallas, Texas, to meet Dr. Becca Peixotto. Becca is an archaeologist who helped uncover a new member of our ever-growing family tree, Homo naledi.
An ad came up, and it was for archaeologists or paleoanthropologists who had caving and climbing experience. I took a chance to apply for the job, and I thought, I'll never hear anything. And then 3 weeks later, I'm underground in South Africa.
Becca was one of 6 women selected to help remove Homo naledi from deep underground.
Together, we made a really solid team, and we all sort of played off each other's strengths to do all of this excavation to find Homo naledi.
So far, Becca and the team have discovered at least 18 individual Homo naledi skeletons, and they found more ancient human fossils than all previous fossil discoveries combined.
Erica, I'd like you to meet somebody special here at the museum. This is Neo.
Hello, Neo. Nice to meet you. He's very focused on something over there.
Yeah, I think he's looking at his own bones here in the case.
I would be distracted too if my own bones were in a case in front of me.
So Neo is Homo naledi.
Homo naledi, that's different than Homo sapiens, but in the same sort of family.
Exactly.
He looks good for his age. How old is he?
The Homo naledi bones are about 250,000 years old.
And this replica was made based off of fossils that you found. That's how they sort of can
exactly,
create.
Exactly.
Fossils are the preserved remains of living things from the past. Long ago, when Neo died, water and minerals from the ground formed tiny crystals around his dead cells, slowly making a perfect stone copy of his bones. Ta-da! Neo and the other Homo naledi fossils were discovered deep inside the Rising Star Cave, a dark, winding underground maze in South Africa.
What was the journey in that cave like?
It's not easy to get where these fossils are. It's dark. It's completely dark. There's no light down there at all.
Becca and her team had to lower themselves into the cave, belly crawl, and then squeeze through a chute 18 centimeters wide.
You as a human have to be able to fit through something that's just a little wider than a dollar bill.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
The museum even installed an exhibit where visitors can give that tight squeeze a try.
There you go. You're doing it.
You got those lanky arms.
There you go.
Of course, here I'm about to just...
Oh! Nice work. Nice job.
Now, imagine doing that in the dark, upside down, in a spooky cave filled with ancient skeletons. And then once you get to where you're going, you have to painstakingly unearth the fossils. To give the visitors this experience,
lights!
They have set up a simulation.
All right.
There we go.
Okay.
When we're excavating, we don't usually dig straight down because you might damage something.
I'm nervous right now. I might be on top of something. Bones! Fingers?
Bunches. Yeah, that does look like a hand. One of the really exciting things we found in the Naledi chamber when we were excavating Homo naledi was an articulated hand. That means almost all the bones in the hand were in their correct anatomical position. Just like you did, tracing each little bone out and thinking about where the next one would be. That's how we excavated it. And it took us probably 2 days to excavate that hand.
Just a hand?
Just one hand.
Two days.
So far, Becca and the team have found over 2,000 naledi bones. We've been practicing with plastic models, but some of the real fossils, the actual 250,000-year-old bones of Homo naledi, are here, and we get to see them up close.
It's not happening, but I just feel like there's like a like aura around this.
I've spent a lot of time with these bones, and still, when I open up the cases and I pick up the bones, it's a really special thing. These things are World Heritage objects. They're part of our shared heritage as humans on the planet.
Literally holding history in your hands when you, that, it is so cool.
The discovery of Neo and Homo naledi has expanded the story of human history in ways no one expected. And Becca thinks this is only the beginning.
We seem to have rediscovered exploration. Like, what are we going to discover? What kinds of new ideas are people who are coming up today and becoming scientists for the future, what are they going to think of that we should learn about? And how is that going to change how we see ourselves and how we see our world?
Well, I'm convinced. Time to go dig in the mud.
Do you love videos like this? Or how about this? Well, I have like a million more videos I want you to see. Go subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on exclusive videos like this one.